Hello?
Hello?
Hello, the extreme!
What's up? Let's do this!
What's Lindsay doing?
Oh, just watching TV.
Hey, let me ask you, does Lindsay ever play video games with you?
No, I tried to a couple times, but she just hates it, so she just kind of does her own thing.
No, Taylor never plays either, I don't get it.
Yeah, man, I don't know, Lindsay's the same way, they're intimidated, I think.
She's like scared to play or something, anytime I mention it, she like runs into the other room. I just don't understand.
Yeah, I wish there was something we could do to get them more interested in games.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech. When the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach. High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Blithe and becoming, and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Ah, agony, far more painful than yours. When you know she would go with you.
Kinda weird, man.
If there only were doors. Agony, oh, the torture they teach. What's as intriguing or half so fatiguing as what's out of reach? Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming as kindness, I'm handsome, and heir to a throne? You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why now?
Do I know?
The girl must be mad.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her agony,
misery,
although it's different for each. Always 10 steps behind, always 10 feet below, and she's just out of reach. Agony that can cut like a knife. I must have her to wife.
You know I can hear every word you're saying, right?